Birds are everywhere.
Birds? Yeah, birds.
They're all around us, in the wings of our everyday lives.
Birds!
With 11,000 species and at least 50 billion birds worldwide, that's 6 birds for every human on this planet.
You did say birds.
Birds inspire art, literature, and music, and they connect us to the natural world, reminding us of our own need for flight, for freedom. They've conquered the globe in a way most other animals, humans included, can only dream of. Birds are survivors, adventurers, innovators. Simply put, they don't share our planet. We share theirs.
There's a lot of reasons why people should care about birds. My number one is that they're just cool. They fly, they come in infinite colors and shapes and sizes. They're just kind of amazing. I think that in and of itself is probably enough. Also are really useful indicators of how the planet is doing, how our ecosystems are doing, and that's really important because it tells us how we're doing too.
Humans have been fascinated by birds since the beginning of our existence, but birds were around for millions upon millions of years before our time. Their lineage can be traced back to the Triassic period, and they're the last remaining descendant of the group that included dinosaurs. But birds give us a glimpse into more than just the distant past of our planet.
One of the reasons we study birds is because birds are indicators of the broader world outside us. And so we should actually care about our environment and the health of our environment because that does so much that makes our life good. And so if the birds are healthy, if we have good populations of birds, then that means that we also have a healthy ecosystem. Birds also just do lots of useful things for us.
And that list is lengthy. Some of the ways birds contribute to ecosystems includes dispersing seeds, pollinating plants, regulating insect and rodent populations, and preventing the spread of disease by scavenging carcasses. These seemingly small actions loom large in ensuring the health of our planet. For their entire existence, birds have developed an intricate, complex relationship with the natural world. Few animals can navigate it as fluently, especially when it comes to migration. Although many migratory species exist in the animal kingdom, from butterflies to whales, birds have truly mastered this art. Motivated by the desire to find more suitable conditions for survival, such as the availability of resources, suitable breeding grounds, and optimal climates, certain birds make remarkable journeys, as exhibited by the 8 major flyways across the globe. The Arctic tern, for example, has the longest migration of any bird, going back and forth from the Arctic to the Antarctic. But our changing planet presents challenges to these birds and their treks.
Phenology is a fancy scientific word for seasons, the seasonality of ecological effects. So we actually study how climate change is impacting the seasons. And that could be leaves coming out, flowers emerging, but often because I'm an ornithologist, we're actually studying when birds migrate, when birds build nests, when birds lay eggs. All of the different parts of a bird's annual life cycle is one of the things we're studying.
As recorded temperatures on Earth have risen, research shows that the seasons have shifted in kind. For example, the average length of the growing season in the US has increased by nearly 2 weeks since the beginning of the 20th century. This means shorter and warmer winters, earlier springs, and longer summers. So what does a warming world mean for birds' migration?
One of the issues we're most worried about with the changing seasonality with climate change is that birds might not be able to keep up with the other parts of nature. So as spring gets earlier, flowers are coming out earlier, insects are emerging earlier, but many of the birds that live here in California and other parts of North America actually leave here in the winter. And if they cannot come back early enough in the spring, then they might actually miss out on food and other types of resources.
Another change that birds have to contend with is a higher incidence of wildfires. While humans may have the luxury of retreating indoors to escape the haze, birds and other wildlife cannot. And the smoke from these fires can travel thousands of miles. In California alone, UCLA scientists have linked wildfire smoke with reduced bird activity and health.
Birds adapt their behavior to different environmental conditions in a lot of different ways. There's a lot of different options they have to changing conditions. That being said, they can't adapt infinitely to all of the conditions that humans throw at them. But they are surprisingly smart sometimes.
And ultimately, the climate and environmental changes they've adapted to have in large part been caused by us, known as anthropogenic effects, which include pollution, climate change, agriculture, livestock farming, and industrial processes. They significantly impact bird populations.
So climate change is a big one that is impacting birds. Another is any sort of like land use change. So deforestation is a huge one. As we lose more critical habitat for birds, birds become displaced. They don't know where to go. They get confused. Oftentimes you'll see birds starting to wander into more urban areas in search of food. And then they meet a whole host of competitors there as well as humans. Noisy cars, and there's just so many things that are very disorienting for birds in city environments.
With a rapidly increasing urbanized human population, the world that birds know continues to transform, leaving them with no choice but to adapt or else. And many do. Birds can be divided into three groups: urban avoiders, urban suburban adapters, and urban exploiters. For example, some birds flying at night may become disoriented by light pollution from cities and homes, avoiders, while other birds learn to use light to hunt for a midnight snack, adapters, and others thrive in human-centric environments, exploiters. But some challenges may be insurmountable. Humanity's impact, including the use of pesticides, has caused a major decline in insects, a food source for 90% of all bird species at some point in their life. But what can be done?
The range of options that we have to try and help birds is pretty limitless. That includes things like protecting habitats, providing resources. If we have our own yards or gardens, we can plant native species that provide food and shelter for birds, help them, give them a place to live and breed and reproduce and feed that can allow them to actually survive and adapt to a changing world on their own.
On a larger scale, people can become more proactive and conservation-minded. Preserve and support forest, wetlands, and other natural habitats, create more green spaces within cities. On an individual level, we can avoid using pesticides and chemicals that harm birds and their food sources. We can keep our pet cats indoors. We can make windows and reflective outdoor surfaces bird-friendly to prevent deadly glass collisions. Adopt and advocate for more environmentally friendly practices and products. And of course, we have the option to participate in crowdsourced science, where everyday people can assist researchers, as well as find ways to educate others and raise awareness about bird conservation issues.
Birds are really important because their status and their presence signals a lot of information for the rest of their habitat or their ecosystem. And birds also provide a lot of vital ecosystem services. So they keep our natural environments healthy and thriving. So we really need to have these birds for years to come in order to maintain a balanced world.
Want to be a more effective avian ally? Join the flock and get involved with crowdsourced science today.